Hello guys, today we'll continue upload Justice Ace Attorney. So in the last video, we in the part where Valan start to tell what happened to Tamala. Anyway, Tamala? What I mean is Tamala, the mother of Tracy. Load. See the profile. Oh, Thalassa! Thalassa, I mean Thalassa, not Tamala. I even wonder why. Is it Tamala? It happened one day when we were practicing same trick with a new twist. And tragedy. But as for whose bullet stole Thalassa's life, or it stole? We shall never know the answer. Thalassa disappeared from our life and Zack was befriended of his wife. Tracy lost her mother. And Manicfi, his daughter. And that led to blackmail, I take it. It is all part and parcel of the darkness that comes when the curtain falls. The darkness? Why did Manicfi Gamery try to cover up the accident? It was his own daughter who died. All I can say is it was a critical time for Troop Gamery. A passing of the torch from Magnifi to Zack and Valen, we are sacrificed so that it might be a success. Thalassa's death was the greatest, greatest sacrifice of all. Yet, even when her life was extinguished, her presence was not. What do you mean? In time, we, myself and Zack found we could no longer oppose Magnifi's wishes. Magnifi forced us to perform his dart for his benefit. I see, I guess I can understand. I mean, he did lose his only daughter. But do you not find cowardice in his actions? Huh? To decide to hide the truth of your own daughter's death is one thing. But then to hang that death as a guillotine above our heads? Things were dark behind the scenes in Troop Gamery, that's for sure. Let's trust him now. She was not told, naturally. Who would want to know what that their father might have taken their mother's life? True. I had not thought of that accident for a very long time. I am sorry to dredge up old memories, but this has helped a lot. Not to find Nifty Slayer, I should think. True. After that accident, there was one who came sniffing quite persistently. A reporter. He called himself a newsman at the time. Often I spied him lurking about the dressing room doing his research. Would you happen to remember his name? What was his name? Sorry, I have forgotten. But in the course of his interviewing, he became quite close to my partner Zack. I like him not. I see. His name, I do not recall, but he sent the cloying aroma of mint. Yes, whenever he smiled, which was far too often. I see. Thanks for your help. It does not no good to interfere with the past, Mr. Wright. You will not uncover answers, only wounds. I am sorry. I had begun to notice a dark curtain hanging over Troop Gamery. And I began to realize what I had to do. I had to protect Tracy from the darkness. The reporter he mentioned. The newsman, I never learned who that was at the time. Though I got a pretty good idea who it is now. That smile and that sickly sweet smell of mint. The last floss tin thread connecting Zack Gamery to this world. Sooner or later, I have to track him down. Yay! Okay. Drew Studio. Interesting. Whoa, Sunshine. Whoa, interesting, interesting. I see, I see. Present day Drew Studio. Eh? Well, what do we have here? remember me? Of course I remember you, journalist made ex-attorney in bar, end quote. Can I ask what you're doing here? Mr. Michel was poisoned and his daughters. Oh yes, I know, I know. Oh, how I know, yes. It caused me no end of grief, to be honest. Journalist wishes he tracked down case just a little quicker, end quote. Were you on the trail of this case the whole time? Ted Gamery was a good friend. There's something to that effect back at the Bulls Ball Club. What a character, what a man. If a little, no a lot, no extremely rough around the edges. Do you think I could ask you a few questions? Oh, you serious? I mean, I'm usually not the interviewer, not interviewee. Journalist ask question, not the other way around, end quote. Fine, shoot, I don't care. People have been asking me all sort of things lately. Talk. Family of Forgers. It was tragic what happened to Drew Misham and his daughter. Forgery is a serious crime and they paid the price. You know what really did. Domindo, do you, don't you? Yes, a forged diary page. The night I interviewed him, I found out something about Mr. Misham I had known. What's that? You know, he always felt like he was being watched. Every day for 7 years, walls have ears, potatoes have eyes, end quote. Being watched? You mean he felt guilty? No, 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 I'm not talking about feelings here. You know, I felt watched too. The whole time I've been on this case, no less. Journalist gets tingling sensation on back of neck, freak outs, end quote. Because you felt guilty? Why would I feel guilty? You felt like you were being watched. Oh, I wonder what it all means. Rumi Shem felt like he was being watched. And you along with him. You sure it wasn't just nerves? Nerves? No, it's nothing so mundane. I stopped paying attention to my nerves a long time ago. But I felt it too. Generally sure he is being watched, end quote. Don't you wonder why Zack got dropped out after 7 years? Right after coming into contact with me? He completely vanished from that courtroom. Then for 7 years he talked to no one, not a soul. Then just as the remaining time was almost up, he contacts me in order to have this made. And then he dies. Starting to put the pieces together, are we? And you were being watched this whole time? Maybe not just me, maybe you're too. Me? Well, that is a possibility. I met Zack through that case, yes. Actually, you mean the shooting of Magnifique Gamery? No, before that, it's not widely known. Oh, you mean the accident during the quick draw shooting practice? My, you were informed. You should have seen me back then, I dug up quite the scoop. I wanted it all, money, fame, woman, a little puppy, all for me. I was younger then and my days and nights smell of fresh and mean than they do now. Colin Gamery did mention one particularly nosy reporter. In fact, I was on close speaking terms with Magnifique Gamery at the time. I knew his daughter too, of course. Thalassa was it? Really? Then Thalassa disappeared quite suddenly at that. And if he won't say a word about it. Yeah, my evil habit got the better of me. Journalist catches scent of a scoop, goes on feeding frenzy, end quote. I set up a one-on-one interview with Thalassa's husband, see? Zack Gamery. Something strange was in the air over at the Troop Gamery in those days. The whole screwy mentor controlling disciples scene started by then, I'm guessing. Thalassa, she was part of it all, right? Come on, you can tell me off the record. Sorry, I do not know. Anyway, I kept praying and eventually became friends with Zack. Sure, he punched me once or twice or five times. Wow. But over time, he came to see me as his confidant. That's the interesting ways to become friends, Alan Gamery. He's been waiting this whole time, 7 years, eh? Waiting. For his big comeback, of course. A big revival of Magnifique Miracle, of course it was all a dream. Because because of this, the performance rights. In the absence of any official documents, he was golden. Who's to say the old man didn't give his right to both Zack and Velen? So, Velen waited until Zack died legally at least. The time finally comes and Velen's like a kid on Christmas morning. He's getting ready for his show at the Sunshine Coliseum, you know. If that document sees the legal light of day, it's going to put a bit of damper on the big show. He's a sorry one, that Velen Gamery. Also his partner at work and in love too. Love? It's the same old story, Lily. Oh, triangle of story, I guess. Two disciples and their mentor's only daughter. What has three sides and all of them pointy? A love triangle. That is pretty classic. When you're in a performing troupe, that's your world. It's like family. One with an entire high school worth of drama, intrigue, and backstabbing. And in the middle of all this, Thalassa has Tracy. And then she dies. I need to find out more about this Thalassa. Present? Magnifique Diary? Michelle, do you know this person? Do I know that person? Of course! I was friends with Zack after all. He hit me a few times. 5 times actually. But still, I never forget his wife. Thalassa Gamery. Magnifique Gamery's only daughter. Do you think you could tell me more about her? Well, why the heck not? Nice! Thalassa. So, Thalassa married Zack and had Tracy, see? It was her second marriage, actually, what? You mean she was divorced? I had heard this one before. Not quite, her late husband was a performer too. He died in an accident on stage. Tragic, really, they had only been married 1 year. I didn't know. Ah, but she was a beauty. I still carry a portrait of her around. You know what? Why you bring it around? Oh. Okay. And on transition, since she was a little thing too, she got the better deal, really. She got you for family after all. What do you mean? Just reminiscing, you know. Thalassa has another child besides Tracy. End quote. What? Who? What? But Tracy said she was an only child. Ah yes, this one she had with her previous husband. Her previous husband? Oh my god, the troop Gamery is very complicated, huh? I can see why Zack Gamery acting like that. Her previous husband? Her first husband who died on stage? Yep, they had themselves a kid. Another orphan now. There's another one who slipped through the cracks. No idea where they are now. So we need to search someone with the brown hair. Okay, got it. Wait! Phoenix Wright? Wait, no, I mean Apollo? Wait, let me see. He has a brown hair! We see later. We see later. Thalassa has another child? You think I could borrow the photo? That photo? Sure, I can be generous on occasion, you know. Thalassa's portrait added to the court record. Okay. I won't need this locket anymore. Better return it to Tracy before I forget. People and events all get tangled together and get bigger and bigger. Don't you think? I was too busy wondering about Big Girl to listen to what you were saying. Sometimes you just gotta accept that you won't be able to untangle it all, I think. Maybe so, but still, I have to do what I can. And I have to tell what I find to those who come next. Next, you say? I'm not the one who will close the curtain on this little play. Apparently, that's not my role anymore. Magnifique. Hmm? I was just wondering what Magnifique will think of all this. What do you mean? Haven't you seen it in Tracy? She's got his power. You mean how I can lie to Tracy? It was the same with Magnifique and with his daughter, Thalassa. It's a strange thing. You think it's some gamer's gene? Magnifique told me once back when Zack married Thalassa, he said Zack got had good eyes, but not good like gamer's eyes, not that good. I wonder if Zack ever played a game of poker with his wife. Who knows what the gamer's secret was? Maybe nobody know that Zack's gone. Zack Gamery. The plot has finally begun to reveal itself. It sprouted from a warp in the Gamery's fabric and grew, swallowing everything, wrapping itself around the Gamery's power. A power which passed from Magnifique Gamery to Thalassa to the next generation. And I will once again need to meet the one who breached it all together. Yay! Enemy! Okay. Okay, wait, let me see the before the present. Okay, so I just need to finish the Drew Studio. You know what? I will try. Talk Magatama. You're hiding something. Let's hear it then. What are you hiding from me, Mr. Nisham? I'm sorry, but I really don't know. I never meet the client. True, when I asked the client's name, there were no physics locked inside. Regardless, you're hiding something. You have to be, otherwise it won't make any sense. Why are you doing this to me? Well, I made my stand, not backing down now. So what's Nisham hiding? Sample, the forger. It's between these two. The forger. I can pretty much piece together what it is from what you said. What is it then? You told me that you knew about the client, and I couldn't see any physical locks. Physical locks? Is there some sort of asylum security or a new hairstyle perhaps? Then they did show up, didn't they? Who was your client? As I said in court, I do not know. Really? Even for such a suspicious request? If it was me, I want to know as much as I could about the requester. I never met them. Not personally, those were triggers the physics lock. Again, when the physical locks, now I really must know what they are. So you didn't meet the client. But someone else did. Maybe the real forger behind the this evidence. Perhaps I hung up on this lock business. But I'm afraid you lost me. Yeah, well, I didn't come here to talk about physics lock. As long as I come to the right conclusion, it doesn't matter how I got there. And your conclusion is the real forger behind this was the new Mr. Nisham. Okay, I will not say that word. I don't know what you're talking about. That's my work, I tell you. Made here in my studio, who else could it have been but me? That's the real question, isn't it? If the forger wasn't you, then I don't have many other people to choose from. Edit folder at the Blue Studio is... Okay... Oh, cute! Present. Edit folder is your daughter, Vera Misham, isn't it? Ridiculous! My daughter's only 12 years old, Mr. Wright. I've always been more one of landscape, not surrealism. Nice comeback, but you're shaking in your boots. I got you now. You only need two people with access to the studio are you and your daughter. The physics logs tell me you're not the forger, which makes your daughter the only possibility. Ahem. I feel very much on the verge of going physical log myself. Nice. Magnificent diary. I don't know how you knew, but you're right. The only one who made this page was my daughter Vera, not I. She's only 12 years old, and she's only 12, a genius, you might call her. A precious little girl outshining her dad's father. There's been a lot of that going around recently. I let her play in the studio and she watched me. She taught herself in that way. The drafting tools, analytic devices I bought when they became necessary. They're my little girl's plaything now. Do I detect a bit of fatherly pride? So Vera was the only one who made this page? But she know who the client was then? Actually, the client came once. Here, to the studio. What? Why didn't you say sooner? But their face was covered and they didn't want to talk to me. So they talked to your daughter? I will speak only with the artist, the client told me. Oh, so they knew. Okay. That little girl might know something about him. Your daughter. Okay, what do I do now? Maybe I should talk to her father a bit more. Or is it time to turn my attention to Vera? Talk to Vera now. Mr. Misham, I have a request. Let me guess. You like to meet to speak with my daughter. Can I? My daughter has never been one to talk to strangers. She's quite shy, extremely so actually. With only one exception, which was, oddly enough, it was that client. I left the studio while they talked. I returned when they had finished and she was laughing. It was the first time I've seen anything of the sort. Please, let me speak with her. Alright. Uh-oh, this could be a tough... Vera. Vera, was it? Would you like to have a friendly chat? I'm Phoenix Wright, ex-lawyer and a pianist. I'm still looking for the keys that say Doremi, can't find them anywhere. I'm no good at this. I need something to get through to this girl. The forgeries. Vera, was it? Would you like to have a friendly chat? Okay, it's the same thing. Present. What do you think about this? I think I just made her nervous. I need something to grab her attention, but what? Oh wait, it's not that? Interesting. Kumrati stamp. And then there's this. My stamp. Hey, she spoke! She can talk! Nice. Okay, that's it for today's guys. Bye-bye!